in a magnetic field. If we put a bar of soft iron material, then it will align to magnetic field and provide minimum reluctance path for the flux. All the flux passes through this ferromagnetic material, and magnetic poles are created accordingly. In the last video, we have discussed 4x2 poles variable reluctance motor. In this video, we will discuss 8x6 pole variable reluctance motor that can operate with reduced angle of step size. Now let us discuss the configuration of stepper motor that can operate with reduced step size. Here, stator has total 8 poles that are energized with 4 phase and the rotor has total 6 pole. This configuration is popularly known as 8x6 pole variable reluctance stepper motor. The 8 stator poles are shifted 45 degrees and energized with 4 pair of stator windings as shown. The 2 sets of concentric windings in each pair are connected in series. For example, winding A and winding A prime are connected in series. This pair of winding is referred as phase A. The case for other phases is also similar to this. The rotor doesn't carry any winding, and it has a total 6 poles shifted by an angle of 60 degrees. The sequence of excitation will be phase A, then phase B, phase C, phase D, then again phase A and so on. When phase A is switched on, the equilibrium position of the rotor is shown here. In this position, flux travels through a minimum reluctance path using rotor pole 1 and 4. This is a stable position of the rotor. Now, if we turned off phase A and simultaneously turn on phase B, then orientation of stator MMF is shifted along the B phase. Now this rotor position cannot offer the minimum reluctance path for the stator flux. So the rotor rotates in such a direction so that their poles align to stator pole. Hence, the rotor poles closest to this B phase pole will align along this MMF. As shown in figure, rotor pole 6 and 3 will align to B phase. This will result in clockwise 15 degree rotation of stepper motor. The step size can be determined from the difference of stator pole pitch and rotor pole pitch. In the next turn, phase C is turned on, and rotor pole 5 and 2 will align themselves to this stator MMF. And as a result, rotor travels another 15 degree in clockwise direction. This way, turning on phases sequentially, the orientation of stator MMF shifts, and rotor try to catches the MMF and stepwise rotation can be obtained. The step size can be calculated using difference of stator pole pitch and rotor pole pitch. We can also calculate step size using this equation, where NS is the total number of stator pole and NR is the total number of rotor pole. The micro stepping can also be obtained by turning on two phases simultaneously. The sequence will be phase A, then phase A and B, then phase B, then phase B and C and so on. The reverse rotation in anti-clockwise direction can be obtained by reversing the phase sequences. The sequence will be phase A, then phase D, then phase C, then phase B, then phase A and so on. Note that the direction of MMF will not matter in case of variable reluctance stepper motor. The one cycle of excitation of 4 phases will complete total 60 degree rotation, and hence total 6 such cycles are required to complete full revolution. Hope now you understand the concept of variable reluctance motor. Please subscribe the channel and share with the others. Thank you.